At the moment, there is no vaccine or known cure for this new virus. What we do know is that it most likely passed from animals to humans in a market in the Chinese city of Wuhan, and it's believed to have likely originated in bats.
Past 2 weeks, the number of cases of COVID-19 outside China has increased 13-fold. We have therefore made the assessment that COVID-19 can be characterized as a pandemic.
Almost 9,000 people in the UK have now lost their lives to coronavirus in the past 5 weeks. And the government has repeated again the need for people to stay at home
as this virus continues to ravage the world.
In Italy, it's now 2 weeks since it went into almost total lockdown, and yet the number of cases there continues to rise.
Now more than 56,000 cases.
The latest daily death toll has risen by a record 980 people.
Quiet neighbourhoods and closed cafes in Paris as France begins a new lockdown.
The coronavirus, you know that. Coronavirus.
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 Coronavirus. Virus.
A huge logistical effort to get the PPE to the front line.
Total US cases have now topped 5 million.
If at all possible, you stay at home.
India has become the latest and largest country to introduce a nationwide lockdown.
Pure desh mein. Sampurna lockdown hone ja raha.
World Health Organization ki report batati hai.
1,787 मरीज हैं, सबसे ज्यादा 9,318 मरीज महाराष्ट्र में.
Over 16,000 cases and close to 600 deaths. Pune, after Mumbai, is a major concern for Maharashtra.
As you all know that COVID pandemic is there, the intensity of which is going on increasing. We are in city of Pune, which happens to be the hotspot of COVID pandemic, and we are still getting large number of COVID positive cases every day. I still remember on 16th or 17th of March, there was a lady who came to us with breathlessness, and she was put on a ventilator assuming to be a community acquired viral pneumonia. So as a protocol, we sent a swab to the National Institute of Virology for H1N1, and the next day I got a call from the authorities that she is COVID-19 positive, and I think 10 days of ventilation and 4 days in the ICU, she went walking home. And again, that was a turning point, and it's a sigh of relief for us. Since we were unable accredited lab, we applied for the testing, and it is a very right move that we started testing right earlier in the RT-PCR or the antigen testing. So everything was in-house.
So when the first patient was diagnosed in last week of March in the Bharti Hospital, I could see war coming against the COVID-19 infection. That time, as an administrator, I need to devise a war strategy. And amongst that, first thing was important was to develop a hospital in hospital. When we identified this area which will have direct access from the roadside, we had to change the infrastructure inside to make it as a outpatient department and also the flu isolation ward. The main challenge was there during the lockdown, people were not available to make the changes. The raw material was not available to make the changes, so we had to really plead to vendors and tell them that we wanted to change it to a COVID dedicated center. So we need a raw material. So we could get that with very much difficulty. We could get a manpower to change the infrastructure, and within weeks time, and we could change and start our flu isolation OPD and ward of 30 beds. But at the same time, as the COVID started spreading, we realized that there is no point in only having an isolation ward. We need to escalate to treating serious patients, critically ill patients. So we converted one of our ICUs into a COVID ICUs, which was 30-bedded ICUs. And at the same time, we started additional 90 beds. So total of 150-bedded COVID-dedicated center was established on April 12.
त्याच्यासाठी आम्ही एक डेडिकेटेड प्लॅन केला की कोविडचे पेशंट कुठे ॲडमिट करायचे आणि त्यांना कशी प्रकारे केअर द्यायची आणि काय सिस्टीम आणि काय प्रोसेसेस तिथं असतील. ते वॉर्ड ओपन करताना आम्हाला बऱ्याचशा गोष्टींच्या प्रॉब्लेम्स होते. म्हणजे स्टाफ नर्सेस जे स्टेईंग इन द हॉस्टेल, त्या इतक्या घाबरलेल्या होत्या की त्या अचानक सगळ्या घरी गेल्या त्यांच्या.
When the people came to know about the lockdown and the COVID is going to start, we have around 500 sisters staying in the campus. 225 of them just left the guest house in the night and just had an exodus.
We have no sufficient nursing staff to take care of COVID patients. But this challenge is very important and we solve it.
Then I thought I should have a series of meetings. So in those initial 15-20 days, every day afternoon I kept small group meeting of 40-50 people and I probably address at least 50 gatherings in those 15 days, asking for giving a positive impetus ki how should we work.
So we had to take a lot of series of meetings with nursing staff, our healthcare workers, your doctors and sisters, and motivate them to work for COVID-19 patients, because this kind of medical emergencies come once in century.
In COVID, when we are treating, it's different from the non-COVID side. So when you are treating diabetes, blood pressure or stroke, you don't have fear of getting it to yourself. But in COVID, yes, there is a risk of infection to the person who is giving the treatment, who is giving the care. So nurses and doctors and mama moshis, they are at the risk of getting infected. So it increases lots of physical stress as well as the mental one. Because with the PPE on, there are limitations to the movement. So it's quite stressful and difficult to work, and then the stress, that's a day-to-day work in the COVID for the last 6 months. These are one of the challenges which we face in COVID, apart from the disease itself. So protect ourselves, protect the nurses, and then treat the patient. The
most important challenge was procuring a PPE. Then when we started procuring the PPE, the cost was exorbitant. Second point, to get a PPE from the vendors, because there were very few vendors who could supply a PPE. So that was really challenging, and we were used to get just barely adequate 1 week stock. But at the same time, the Pune Municipal Corporation has really helped us to give PPE for our healthcare workers, including doctors, nurses and staff. So that was a challenge. And then as an administrator, it was my responsibility that every healthcare worker get an adequate level of protection.
This challenge, it started on 20th of March, when the first lockdown was arranged. So it started with the scarcity of the food for the residents. So finally contacted our local caterer who routinely the supplies for our events in the hospital, and he readily agrees to provide the food to the doctors. Once the COVID hospital started, it was our responsibility to provide food to the COVID patients also. So food was being started for the people who were working in the COVID ward as well as the COVID patients.
So when COVID-19 hit us, there were no drugs out. Whenever there are no drugs to treat a particular illness, especially viral illness, then what generally happens is you repurpose available drugs. Remdesivir, I mean, what should happen? The mortality should come down. So for a drug to reduce mortality now, yeah, it has to prevent progression of disease. That has not been shown.
So I remember this episode around in August when we had 6 to 8 deaths in the units. That makes me think whether the things are going right or not. It's not good on the intensivist part to see your patients die, but you try your best, and at the end of the day, we have to move on with the things. We had one episode in August, unfortunately, one patient died, and the relatives created a walkout of it. They barged inside the ICU. So that was very intimidating for the staff. But these things, we need to handle it and then move on, because this is to stay for longer. So we have to continue with the patients who are on the positive side. The same day, within 2 hours, I got a call from the patient's son from the US. His father had died in the morning. So we thanked the entire team of the ICU for the better care, whatever the care we gave to the patient. And that is, again, the two sides of the coin.
When my father entered into the hospital, and he got a bed in the hospital, and then his mild illness, it became a moderate illness, it required oxygen. I could see the future of the disease in my father. So it was really a difficult moment for me to work as an administrator also, and to work as a family member and take care of my family. But then I could overcome it, I could balance it, and with the help of my team in Bharati Hospital, my father successfully underwent a treatment, and he could be discharged without much complications after 18 days of treatment at Bharati Hospital.
I'm very proud of the I'm a nurse and help in the COVID pandemic situation. I have a 3 years old child. तिला मी बेबी क्रशमध्ये ठेवते. आय हॅव ऑल्सो डायबिटीस. मग मला ही भीती होती की आय हॅव कोमॉर्बिडिटीज, मग कसं मी टॅकल करायचं. पण माझाच आय एम व्हेरी ट्रस्टेड टुवर्ड्स अ गॉड की मी एकदम प्रामाणिकपणे काम केलेलं आहे आणि मी प्रामाणिकपणे काम करते. त्याच्यामुळे कोविड सिच्युएशनमध्ये माझ्या मुलीला आणि मला काहीच होणार नाही हे मला माहिती आहे, आणि मी असंच काम करत राहील कुठल्याही सिच्युएशन आलं तर टुवर्ड्स अ हॉस्पिटल.
Any government organization coming and facilitating private sector doctors, that tells us that we are really are doing some kind of good work. So in a way we were quite honored that the army people came and they congratulated us for the good work. So it was a wonderful feeling.
So when we were a part of this trial of Serum Institute of India, which is in Pune, largest manufacturer, and the first enrollment of the volunteer took place at our unit, and I think we have not seen so much amount of eagerness among the volunteers, equally eagerness from the media, from the researchers in the country, outside the country. And we, when we enrolled the first candidate on that particular day, I think we were asked, we were talked about, and we could get our name of the hospital probably on every channel, every newspaper in the country and outside the country. I think that moment I will cherish for years to come.
When I always talk about as Bharati Vidyapeeth family. So that showed their dedication to their family. And I'm always going to be very grateful to all of them. They have faced a lot of problems. If you remember, in lockdown, they didn't have buses. They could not travel anywhere. They had to face a lot of hardships. Pune people are very helpful as such. Be it the businessmen, the clubs, the Rotary clubs, the industrialists, even the common people of day-to-day life, they came together. And they came forward and said, no, you guys are great. And I'm very grateful to all our donors who really supported us. We hope and pray that we never see this pandemic again. But I am very, very grateful to each and every member of this Bharati Vidyapeeth medical sector family for the kind of dedication they have shown. And I'll always be grateful to them.